Hello everyone, welcome to class 4. I'm your science teacher and today we will do a short revision of lesson 2 and we'll solve exercise of lesson 2. Now there are few learning objectives of today's lecture. This lesson will help you to understand the role of teeth, to describe the different sets and types of teeth with its function, and to describe the different part of tooth. Unlike pythons, humans cannot swallow food in one big gulp. Food must be broken down into smaller pieces before it can be swallowed. This function is performed by teeth. And do you know what is the position of teeth? Yes, teeth are present inside our mouth. And how do they help us? They help in biting and chewing the food. We have all gone through the phase during our childhood. Do you remember? Where we would lose a tooth and a new one would already be ready below it. As humans, we have two sets of teeth. Temporary teeth and permanent teeth. The first set is called as milk teeth, primary teeth or baby teeth. And they start erupting when we are 6 months old. And the next set of teeth is called permanent teeth. These teeth are very important for the normal growth and development of a child. In fact, as important as your permanent teeth. Though there is a significant difference between milk teeth and permanent teeth, milk teeth perform certain important function until the permanent teeth can take over. By the time a child is 2.5 years old, the first set of how many teeth? 20 teeth appears. Do you want to know how do milk teeth help us? They help the child bite and chew, which is essential for the child to gain proper nutrition, and they allow the proper development of speech. Now this is second set of teeth, permanent teeth. When the child is about 6 years old, milk teeth, which is the first set of teeth, start falling out one by one. Slowly, new ones, means new teeth, which are bigger in size, take their place. Whose place? Milk teeth's place. And this set of new teeth is called permanent teeth. As we all know, how do teeth help us? Teeth are mainly needed to bite and chew the food. But according to their different functions, teeth are of 4 types. According to their function, there are 4 types of teeth. The first is incisors. Your 8 incisor teeth are located in the front part of your mouth. You have 4 of them in your upper jaw and 4 in your lower jaw. Incisors are shaped like small chisel. They have sharp edges that help you bite into food. Whenever you sink your teeth into something such as an apple, you use your incisor teeth. Incisors are usually the first set of teeth to erupt, appearing at about 6 months old. Your four canine teeth sit next to the incisors. You have two canines on the top of your mouth and two on the bottom of your mouth. Canines have a sharp, pointy surface for tearing food. The first baby canines come in between the age of 16 months and 20 months. The upper canines grow in first, followed by the lower canines. Your 8 premolars sit next to your canines. There are 4 premolars on top and 4 on the bottom. Premolars are bigger than canines and incisors. They have a flat surface for crushing and grinding food into smaller pieces to make it easier. Baby molar teeth are replaced by adult premolars. Infant and young children don't have premolars because these teeth don't start to come until around the age of 10. Your 12 molars are your biggest and strongest teeth. You have 6 on the top and 6 on the bottom. The main 8 molars are sometimes divided into your 6 years and 12 years molars based on when they typically grow in. The large surface area of your molars help them grind up food. When you eat, your tongue pushes food to the back of your mouth. Then your molars break up the food into pieces small enough for you. The molars include 4 wisdom teeth, which are the last set of teeth to come in. They usually come in between the age of 17 and 25. Wisdom teeth are also called third molars. We all know that teeth are hard, mineral-rich structures which are used to chew food. They are not made of bone like the rest of the skeleton, but have their own unique structure. A tooth has a crown and a root. The crown is the part we see, whereas the root is the part inside the gums. Gums hold the teeth in their places. The white part on the outside of a teeth is called enamel. It is the hardest substance in the human body. Below the enamels lies the hard dentine. Inside the dentine lies the pulp. And this pulp is very soft and full of nerves and blood vessels. The pulp forms the central part of the tooth. As teeth are very important, proper care of teeth is very important. When we eat, tiny bites of food get stuck in spaces between our teeth. We need to clean them out, otherwise germs can grow there. Proper brushing with a toothbrush, toothpaste, and water can prevent plaque formation. Now let's revise different ways to protect your teeth. Brush your teeth at least twice a day, once in the morning and once before going to bed. Use up and down motion to brush teeth. Brush the top teeth downwards and the bottom teeth upwards. Brush out the back of the teeth. Brush the flat surface of premolar and molar. Use a tongue cleaner to clean the tongue. Eat food that is healthy for teeth and gums. For example, milk, egg, curd, and green vegetables. Avoid eating too many sweet snacks or soft drinks. Visit the dentist regularly for checkups. Calcium is very important for strong teeth. So, milk and milk products such as curd and cheese, which are rich source of calcium, are helpful for strong teeth. Now here, the diagram given here represent different parts of the human digestive system that convert food into essential nutrients absorbed by the body. The process of digestion starts from the mouth. The process of digestion starts in the mouth, and here food is broken down by biting and chewing. This chewed food mixes with a liquid called saliva, which helps in digestion. Food passes from the mouth through this thin long tube, which is called the food pipe or esophagus. Third is stomach. It is a sac-like organ where food is broken down further. Food from the stomach passes into the small intestine. Here all the useful nutrients are absorbed by the blood and taken to all parts of the body. Liver. Liver produces juices that play an important role in the digestion of food. Large intestine. It holds the food that cannot be digested and absorbs water from it and forms waste called feces. The last step is anus, where feces are removed from the body through this organ. For good digestion system, healthy eating habits are also important. Some healthy eating habits are like chew the food well and do not swallow it whole. Always wash your hands before and after meals. Rinse your mouth well after meals. Always try to eat a balanced diet. Now let's revise the last topic of the chapter, which are microbes. Microbes are very small living thing that cannot be seen with the naked eye. They can be seen only with the help of an instrument called microscope. Microbes are four main type. So here microbes are of four main type. Virus, the first type. Bacteria, the second type of microbe. Fungus, which is the third type of microbe. And protozoa, which is the fourth type of microbes. Microbes can be beneficial to us also. Means there are some uses of microbes. Like some microbes are used in making bread and bun. Some microbes change milk into curd. Some microbes help in the digestion of food. Some microbes helps in the process of rooting of dead plants and animals. Now, we have seen that some microbes are useful and beneficial to us. But there are some harmful microbes which are called germs. They can cause diseases. Like virus cause diseases such as common cold, influenza and polio. Then bacteria caused diseases such as typhoid, tuberculosis and cholera. Fungi cause diseases such as ringworm and athlete's foot. The first question, choose the correct option. First MCQ, in the mouth, food is broken down by, options are drinking, option B chewing, option C sipping, and option D none of this. The answer is chewing, because in the mouth, food is broken down by chewing. And we all know that digestive system diagram labels start from the mouth. In fact, your body starts the digestive process before even you take your first bite of the food. So in the mouth, food is broken down by chewing the food. We break down the food so that it will be easy for our body to digest it. Second is food passes from the mouth through a long tube called, the options are A. Intestine, option B. Anus, option C. Esophagus, and option D. Liver. The answer is C. Esophagus, because it is located in the throat and it is placed near to windpipe. After food is broken down in the mouth, this broken down food passes from this food pipe. Third is useful nutrients from the digested food move into the blood in the, options are A. Small intestine, option B. Large intestine, option C. Liver, and option D. Esophagus. So the answer is small intestine, because all the useful nutrients for our body like carbohydrate, protein, fats, minerals, all the useful nutrients from the digested food, means food which is already digested, that food moves into the blood in these organs. Fourth is, which among the following is not a microbe? So there are four main type of microbes, which are virus, bacteria, fungi and protozoa. So here crown is not a type of microbe. So the answer is crown. Fifth is, the microbes that cause malaria is option A virus, option B bacterium, option C protozoa, and option D fungus. The answer is protozoa, because protozoa is a harmful microbe which causes diseases such as food poisoning and malaria. Now let's see, match the following. Column A, the first word is canines. The answer is tearing food, because canines is a type of teeth which helps in tearing food. Second word is pulp, and it lies inside the dentine, and it is very soft and full of blood vessels and nerves. So we have to match pulp with blood vessels and nerves. Now next word is virus. Virus is again harmful microbe which cause diseases such as common cold and polio. So here the answer is polio. Polio is one kind of disease, and virus is one kind of harmful microbe. Next is protozoa, which is again harmful microbe, and it causes diseases such as food poisoning and malaria. So here malaria is name of the disease, and protozoa is harmful microbe. Next is bacteria, which is harmful microbe and caused diseases such as typhoid and cholera. So here cholera is name of the disease, and bacteria is harmful microbe. Now let's see, write two examples. First, food for strong teeth. The answer is milk and egg. Milk and egg are the examples of food for strong teeth, as teeth are very important for human. We should take care of it, and milk and egg can help our teeth to be strong. Now second is diseases caused by viruses. Your virus is one kind of harmful microbe which causes diseases such as common cold and polio. So here common cold and polio are example of diseases. So these both diseases are caused by viruses, and virus is a harmful microbe. Third, diseases caused by bacteria. Your bacteria is harmful microbe, and diseases caused by it are cholera and typhoid. So cholera and typhoid are one kind of diseases which are caused by bacteria. Fourth, diseases caused by fungi. Fungi is again harmful microbe, and diseases caused by it are ringworm and athlete's foot. So ringworm and athlete's foot are one kind of diseases which are caused by fungi. Fifth, diseases caused by protozoa. Next is diseases caused by protozoa. It is one kind of harmful microbe, and diseases caused by it are food poisoning and malaria. So here food poisoning and malaria are one kind of diseases which are caused by protozoa. Now let's see, write one word for the following. First, teeth for cutting and biting the food. The answer is incisor. We all know, according to their function, there are four types of teeth: incisors, canines, premolars and molars, from which incisors helps in cutting and biting the food. Second is hard white part on the outside of tooth, which is enamel. Third, the soft part of the tooth that contain nerves and blood vessel. The answer is pulp. Fourth, the process by which food is broken down into smaller form, which is digestion. Fifth, harmful microbe that cause diseases are called germs. And there are four harmful microbes: virus, bacteria, fungi and protozoa. Now let's see, fill in the blanks. First, the sticky yellow layer on the teeth is called dash. We all know that when we eat, tiny bits of food get stuck in a space between our teeth. We need to clean them out, otherwise germs can grow there and even it's form a sticky layer which is called plaque. The second is, dash is important for strong teeth. The answer is calcium. We all know that our teeth are very important. So calcium is very important for strong teeth, like milk and milk products such as curd and cheese are rich sources of calcium. So milk and milk product and all other calcium rich food items are very important for strong teeth. Now third, food pipe is also called dish. In digestion system, after food is broken down in a mouth, it passes from the mouth through long tube, which is food pipe and is called esophagus. Now fourth is, dish is a sac like organ where food is broken down. The answer is stomach. Stomach also play an important role in the digestion of food. Now fifth, harmful dash which cause diseases are called germs. So harmful microbes like virus, bacteria, fungi and protozoa, which cause diseases like typhoid, cholera, polio. Now let's see true or false. First, there are three sets of teeth in human being. The answer is false. This statement is false because in human being there are two sets of teeth, permanent set and temporary set. So this statement is false. Second, temporary teeth are also called milk teeth. So this statement is true because the first set of teeth, which is temporary teeth, are also called milk teeth or baby teeth. Now third statement, there are seven incisors in all. This statement is false because there are eight incisors in all, not seven. From that, those eight teeth, four in each jaw, means upper jaw and bottom jaw. Now let's see fourth statement, premolars helps to crush food and chew it. As we all know, there are eight premolars in all, four in each jaw, and premolars helps to crush food and chew it. So this statement is true. Now let's see the next statement. The white part on the outside of a tooth is called the pulp. The statement is false because the white part on the outside of teeth is called enamel. So this statement is false. So today we have revised the topics like set of teeth, type of teeth, parts of tooth, care of teeth, the digestive system and microbes.